Azure Virtual Desktops are becoming very popular with businesses all around the world. But what's the advantages of using a virtual desktop and how do you set them up? Well, in today's video, we're going to talk all about Azure Virtual Desktops. Plus, I'm going to give you a full demo on how you can set up your Azure Virtual Desktop infrastructure. So let's get cracking. But before we do, just a quick intro. My name is Jonathan Edwards from Integral IT in the UK. Now we help businesses all over the world with their Microsoft 365 and their Azure. So what is an Azure virtual desktop? Well, it's a virtual desktop in the cloud. So you go to a web browser, you type in your Microsoft 365 credentials and a full desktop launches right within your web browser. So your desktop includes your email, your files and folders, and all your applications. Now, my IT company, Integral IT, is starting to sell lots and lots of Azure virtual desktops. But why? What are the use cases for these cloud-based desktops? So the best way to explain it, I think, is to look at three use cases. And these three use cases are the last three customers that we have sold an Azure virtual desktop to. Now, the first one is a law firm, and they've got 50 users spread over three separate offices. Now, when we started working with this company, each office acted as a separate IT entity. So they had a server, a physical server in each office. Each office had its own files and folders, its own applications. There was no sharing between the offices. Now, the partners of this law firm wanted to unify their technology. So there was sharing between the whole company. Plus, they wanted a single per user per month price rather than having to buy expensive servers every few years. So the perfect solution was an Azure virtual desktop. A second client we have is based over in the USA. Now they had 10 users, but they had no office. So all 10 users were based at home, but they had an application that they needed to use within the business. Now, because they didn't have an office, they didn't have any central place to install applications. So what's the perfect solution? You've guessed it, an Azure virtual desktop. And a third client we have based quite far away in Australia. So this client employed a lot of contractors, people who worked for them occasionally, but weren't on their payroll. Now they needed to give these contractors secure access to their systems. But what they didn't want to do is buy each contractor their own device, their own laptop. So what's the perfect solution? An Azure virtual desktop. That means the contractors can use their own laptops and they can securely access the data using an Azure virtual desktop. So there are three use cases. Now I think it's time to jump over to that computer behind me and I'll give you a full demo on how to set it up and how it works. Now, partway through this demo, we're going to jump back out and I'm going to give you a bit of advice about the sizing of servers, etc. So let's jump on behind me. Okay, so there's a few areas in Microsoft 365 that I've logged into. Firstly, I've logged into the Microsoft 365 Admin Center with a global admin account. I've also got another tab open here, which is portal.azure.com, and I've logged into here with the same admin account. We'll be doing most of our work in the Azure portal. But what I want to do first is just create a couple of groups, a couple of security groups. Now, this will all become clear later in the video. But if I go to Teams and Groups, Active Teams and Groups, and I want to go over to Security Groups here and add a security group. Now, I'm going to call this AVD, Azure Virtual Desktop Users. I can add a description if I want to as well. Once I've done that, I click on Next. I'll tick on here, I'll click on Next, and then I'll create the group. Next, I'm going to add another security group. I'm going to call this AVD Administrators. Again, if I want to enter a description. And once I'm happy, I'll click on Next. I'll tick this box, I'll click on Next, and I'll create that group. Then I'll click on Close. So these groups are here. So what I'm going to do now is add the users that I want to be able to access the AVD into this group. So I will click on Members here. I'll add Members. Now I'm gonna add Ellie and Fred. So these are the two users in my business that I want to be part of the AVD environment. Okay, add those. Once that's done, I click come out of there. And then the AVD administrators. So these people will have admin access to the AVD servers. So they'll be able to install applications and things like that. The AVD users will just be standard user accounts. So I will add a member here, and I'm going to add my IT admin account there and click on add. Okay, that is done. So I'll close out of there. Now I'm going to go over to the Azure portal. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is add something called a resource group. Now, a resource group in Azure, you've got to think of it like a bucket, okay? So all the resources connected to my Azure Virtual Desktop is going to go into this bucket, and that bucket is called a resource group. So if it's there, we can click on it. Otherwise, we can just search for it at the top, and you can see resource groups appears there, okay? So here's my resource groups already. I'll click on create. Now it's asking us to confirm our subscription. So it goes without saying that to do this, you do need an Azure subscription. I've already got one. Now I'm going to call this something that means something. So what is this resource group going to be called? I'll call it AVD-RG, Azure Virtual Desktop Resource Group. Now what region do I want this to be in? Now it's important that throughout this video, you choose the same region for all your resources. So I'm going to put this into UK South. There we go. I'm going to click on next. I don't want any tags. Click on next. Okay, that's all passed, and click on create. So the next thing I'm going to do is create a virtual network. I'm going to put that virtual network into that resource group bucket that I've already created. Now, obviously we need a network within Azure to run our Azure Virtual Desktop infrastructure. So go on to virtual networks here, and I've got none at the moment. So I click on create. Okay, again, it's saying what subscription do you want to use? This is the one here. And it's already saying, where should I put this? What resource bucket should I put this in? So just make sure that it's the resource group that we've just created. And it is, okay? So now I'm going to give this a name. I'll call this AVD Net or Network. That makes sense to me. Again, it's pointing it in the same UK South data center, the region. So I click on next. We've got a few additional security things that we can apply here. Now, please know a lot of these will incur an extra cost. And for the purpose of this demo, I'm not going to include any. Click on next. And now it's all about IP address spaces. So this is the default it'll give you. We've got a lot of usable IP addresses, much more than we're going to need. I'm going to keep this as the default, but you can change this if you want. Click on next. Again, no tags. And again, let's create that virtual network. Now that deployment is in progress, so we'll leave it a little while. Oh, it's finished, okay. So our virtual network has now been created. Let's just go back to the home tab here. Okay, now let's head over to the Azure Virtual Desktop tab. It's here. Again, if it's not showing, you can just search for it here. So we'll click on Azure Virtual Desktop, and it takes us to here. So we have to do a few things here. We create a host pool, and then we create an application group, and then we create a workspace. So we can create a host pool by clicking here, or we can just go over to here and click create host pool. So again, it's asking us to confirm our Azure subscription, but now the resource group we've got to put in here. So we're going to create this in AVD resource group, and it's going to ask for a name. So I will call this AVD hyphen host pool. At the moment, the location is in East US. I want to change this to UK South. The validation environment will stick to no. And then the preferred app group type. And we've got two options here. We've got desktop or remote app. So a desktop is a full desktop within Azure. So they log on to a full desktop. A remote app is just an application in Azure that you can publish to individual computers. I'm going to leave that as desktop. And then we're going to move on to the host pool type. So what is that? We've got two options. We've got personal or pooled. So with AVD, we are buying a host within Azure. So what we can do, if it's personal, it means one person is logging on to that entire host and they have all the resources for themselves. With a pooled host pool type, you've got multiple people logging onto that one host and sharing the resources. Now, obviously, a pooled host pool type is going to be cheaper and probably the most common option that we'll choose. So I'm going to choose pulled. We've got the load balancing algorithm. We've got breadth first or depth first. So the difference between these two, breadth first will spread users out across all of your hosts. So if you've got four hosts and you've got four users logging onto those hosts, it will put one user on one host, another one on another host, another one on the third one, and another one on the fourth one. With depth, it will, with the same number of hosts, it will fill the first host up. So it's slightly different. We're going to go on depth, and we're going to say the maximum number of users per host is going to be 5. Then we'll click on next. And at this point, we can choose a virtual machine. So I'm going to do that now. Click on yes. Now again, it's going to ask for the resource group, so make sure that is the right one. And then it's going to ask for a name prefix. So you could put something here like company name, like the company. So your first server will be called Your Company 1. The second one will be called Your Company 2, etc., etc. The virtual machine type, let's leave this at Azure Virtual Machine. Again, we need to change the location of the virtual machine to the right one. So this is going to be UK South again. And now we've got a couple of options about availability of our infrastructure. So availability options. We can select the drop down here. We've got no infrastructure redundancy required, or we've got availability zones or sets. So with no infrastructure redundancy required, your virtual desktop infrastructure will be kept in the same region. With availability zones, you can choose to spread these out over different zones. So if there's a problem with a data center at Azure or something like that, you will still access your virtual desktops. Now, I'm going to choose, because the availability zones and sets do cost more money, I'm going to choose no infrastructure redundancy required. I'm going to leave the security type at trusted launch virtual machines, which will check these two boxes here. I'm happy with that. Then we're going to move on to image. So this is basically asking us what image we want on these virtual machines when people log on. And we've got a lot of options here. We can have Windows 10, we can have Windows 11, and we've got different versions. Plus, we can have Windows 11 with installed Microsoft 365 apps. Now, I don't see a reason why you wouldn't go for the latest and greatest. So I'm going to choose Windows 11 23H2 with the Microsoft 365 apps. And now it's going to ask us all about the size of the virtual desktops. Okay, and we've got a lot to choose from here. Now, at this point, it might be quite a good idea just to come out of this demo, and we can talk about my advice when it comes to choosing virtual machines, pricing, auto scaling, etc., etc. So what servers you choose for your Azure virtual desktop will be key to your performance of your virtual desktop, but also the cost of your virtual desktop. The thing with Azure is it can get quite expensive quite quickly. So you've got to be quite clever in how you design your Azure virtual desktop setup. Now in this video, I'm just gonna choose a very basic, very small virtual machine because it's just a test. Now I could probably do an entire video on my advice about sizing virtual machines. And I might do. But for now, let me give you a real world example about how we sized a virtual machine for a recent client of ours. So let's go back to that recent example that I gave you earlier. The law firm with 50 users across 3 offices. How did we design that? Well, we implemented 4 servers, which are called E4S V5s. Now, each of these servers has 4 vCPUs and 32 gig of RAM. So times by 4, you've got the total of 16 virtual CPUs and 128 gig of RAM. But the clever thing we did with this setup is we used the scaling that is built into Azure. So during business hours, Monday to Friday, 9 till 5, all 4 servers are operational. However, outside of business hours, 3 of the 4 servers shut down. So there's only 1 server active, but that can handle the number of users that work outside of business hours. So because of that, because Azure is a pay-per-use model, this is much cheaper than having 4 servers switched on at the same time. That's pretty clever. Okay, I hope all that makes sense. Now I'm going to stick to this standard virtual machine here. It's asking me how many I want of these. Okay, so I'm just going to choose for this demo, just one of them. OS disk type, we can have a standard HDD, a standard SSD, or a premium SSD. I would choose for performance the premium, but it's up to you. Obviously, the premium costs more money. And then we're talking about OS disk sizes. So make sure that this is sized correctly for your environment. We can choose different things. Again, I'm just going to stick to the default size for this tutorial. I'm going to leave the boot diagnostics as it is, and we're just going to scroll down a little bit more. And it's going to ask us now to choose a virtual network. Well, we've already created one of these in a previous video, so that's nice and easy. It's the AVD network. Here's a subnet here. We've got the network security group type. Again, there's a description of all this if you want to dig a little bit deeper. I'm going to leave this as basic. And then we can choose to open some public inbound ports. Now, again, I'm not going to do that because it's a bit of a security risk. We can choose yes, and we can put whatever ports we want into there. I'm just going to select this as no, though, for this tutorial. So do we want to domain join these virtual machines, or do we want to make them part of Microsoft Entra ID? Well, for me, it's going to be Entra ID all day long, but it's up to you. And then we might want to enroll the VM with Intune. Yep, good idea. Let's do that. Next, it's going to ask us to create a local administrator account for the virtual machine. So I'll create one now. And this account will just cover us if we need to log on locally for whatever reason, okay? Click on here, and now it's going to ask us if we want to create a workspace, okay? I'm going to select no for this because I'm going to create a workspace a little bit later, so we do everything logically. But you can do if you want. Click on Next Advanced, and then click on Review and Create, and that host pool will now be created. Click on Create. Okay, the deployment is now complete. That took about 20 minutes to complete, so be patient with that. Now, out of here, just to keep it logical, I'm going to go back to home, and I'm going to go to Azure Virtual Desktop. In host pools, you can see that that has now been created. So the next thing I'm going to do is go to application groups, and you can see that one of these has been created as well. Now, I've not created that. That was done when I created the host pool, okay? Now onto workspaces. Now at the moment, there's no workspace here, so I'm going to click on Create Workspace. Okay, again, it's going to ask me to confirm my resource group that I want to put this in. We'll call this company name, so we'll call this whatever your company name is, our workspace. We can add a description if we want, and again, it's asking for a location. So we're going to dump this in UK South again. Next, application groups. Okay, let's now register the application group by clicking on yes. Click on here. And then we're going to add this to the workspace. Click on select. Click on next or next advanced. We don't want that. We don't want tags. Review and create. Okay, let's create. Okay, we've also now got a deployment complete. Again, let's just into Azure Virtual Desktop. Now let me just show you, if I go into host pools here, you can see I've got AVDHP. If I click into here, you can see now I've got a virtual machine that is running. And here's my virtual machine. So company-0, it's now a running virtual machine. So what do we do next? Well, let's just hop back in here. Let's go to application groups. Let's click on this application group here. Now I'm going to start assigning users to my application group. And this is where the groups that we created earlier will come in. So go to assign, click on add, and I'm going to add my two groups that I created earlier into this assignment. Okay, so they are now added in there. But we've also got to add some other permissions at the resource group level. So if I go back to home and I go to resource groups, and I pick out my AVD resource groups, and then I go to access control here, okay? And then what I need to do, I need to grant some access to this resource group. So we add, and we add a role assignment, and then we search, okay? So if you just type in virtual machine, now you can see here, virtual machine user login. So we highlight that, and we click on next. And then we select members. And again, for this, I'm going to select the AVD users group and click on select, review and assign, and that should add them into there. Okay, we're going to add another role assignment, and this is for the admin side of it. So virtual machine again. You can see I've got virtual machine administrator login. Click on next, select members, AVD administrators. Click on select, click on next, review and assign, and that's been assigned. Okay, just a couple more settings and we can test it. So let's go back to home again. Let's go to Azure Virtual Desktop. Let's go to the host pool. Let's go into the host pool. And we're now going to choose how we want people to access this AVD workspace. So we go to RDP properties and the connection information. Now what I want for this is I want Microsoft Entra single sign-on. At the minute it's saying not configured. And I'm going to select this as connection we use Entra authentication to provide single sign-on. I'm going to click on save. And that has updated the host pool. Okay, so this is all set to go now. So let's just test it, okay? So if I open my Edge window here, the link to access the Azure Virtual Desktop is this one here. So it's rdweb.wvd.microsoft.com. If you browse to that, it will take you to a sign-in page here. So you can access your virtual desktop over the web here. But there's also a remote desktop app, which I'm going to show you now. So if I just go here, you can see I've got a remote desktop app that can be installed on your computer from the Windows Store. So open that, and it'll bring up this tab here. And I can simply click on subscribe, and it's going to ask me for my username and password. So if I log in with Fred, click on next, enter the password, click on sign in. And you can see here that the workspace we've created called Our Workspace is here. And I can just double click now on the session host and that will connect. And you can see that this desktop is now going to load inside of Azure. This is the first time Fred's logged on, so it's just going to take a few more moments to create the profile. And here it is. So you can see I've got a Windows 11 computer. I've got all my Office apps installed on it. I've got File Explorer. I can configure OneDrive on here. It's a full computer in the cloud. I can minimize that lock and it minimizes. I've logged in to a full, Teams is going to load now, a full Windows 11 computer. Okay, once I've finished with that, there's something else I want to do, and that's for security. Okay, so I'm just going to log out of here now. I want multi-factor authentication on my access to Azure Virtual Desktop. So how do I do that? Well, if I come back here, if I go to the Microsoft 365 Admin Center, I go to Identity, and I go to Protection, and I go to Conditional Access, and I go to Policies. Okay, so I'm going to create a new policy. I'm going to call this CA11 because it's my 11th one. I'm going to put okay, we're going to apply this to all users. In fact, what I'll do, I'll just select the users and groups. That's a better idea. So AVD users, the target. Okay, we're going to select the cloud app. We're going to select it. And in there, we're going to search for Azure Virtual Desktop, which is here. Click on select. And we're going to keep that as it is. We're going to go to grant control. So we're going to grant access to it, but we're going to require multi-factor authentication, okay? Click on select, switch that policy on, and click on create. Okay, that policy has now been created. Okay, I'm back on the remote desktop app. And what I've done, I've unsubscribed, and I'm going to resubscribe just so that conditional access policy for MFA can kick in. So click on subscribe, enter the username, next, password, sign in. And now it's wanting me to set up MFA. So I'll do that really quickly. Okay, every time now that I try and subscribe to my workplace, it will ask me for MFA. And then if I try and log in over the web, it should also ask me for, again, so when I log in over the web, it also asks me for MFA. So that is the tutorial. Hooray! So there you have it. There's a demo on Azure Virtual Desktop. So, do you think an Azure Virtual Desktop would suit your business? I hope you've enjoyed this video. Look forward to seeing you again soon.